What's up, everybody? Pizza Beer Revolution, Mike Plano, Derek D. We're back here at the Speakeasy. What up, brother?
What up, dude?
How you doing?
Good to have you here. Okay, turn your phone. Don't you know? Okay.
You know what? That wasn't my phone. That was Dennis the intern's phone. Should we let him? He's here today. He's causing ruckus. Should we let him sit in? We'll get to that in a minute.
Yeah, because where has he been? Like, he just shows up when
he's
wants
here,
to.
He's here, he's not here.
He shows up when he wants to be in it. Dennis!
He causes issues is what he does.
He's not even, what is he, the bathroom?
We'll get to him in a minute.
All right.
We're back at the Speakeasy. We have so many things to talk about today. I don't even know where to begin, man. But the first thing I want to do is let's just go get it out. Let's thank all of the PBR Posse, all the PBR listeners, everybody who's been buying merchandise, listening to the show, posting up on social media. Like, we can't thank you enough. It's been a wildfire as of late, and we thank you.
Thank you so much. Seriously, if you could see me, we don't have the cameras in the studio today, but if you could see me right now, my hands are in the air waving like they just don't care because I'm so excited about that you guys are like, man, they're all over it. The social media, the
liking.
It's
crazy.
It's great. Thank you guys so much. Patreon, thank you. The people that are on there too as well.
Now we have a ton. Dennis does a lot of our social media, so sometimes it'll be the voice of him. Sometimes it's me. Sometimes it's Franki. Sometimes it's Derek. But let's let that idiot come talk for a minute. Dennis,
sit down. Sit down. You're like running around. Stop feeling with.
All right. I'm adjusting.
Let's
Dennis. Everybody,
welcome, Dennis. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's good to be back.
So, I don't know. Talk to us about what's going on with our social media as of late.
It's just been blowing up. I mean, everything's been, you guys are really, liking everything. You guys are sharing. You guys are wearing your shirts. And I'm telling you, we feel the love and we love you back.
Dennis is heavy on that social media, though. You got to give him that.
Yeah. What's the hardest part we're all on there for the most part, but you kind of, as the intern, are the voice of our social media. So, how do you feel about it? Like, I have no idea what I'm trying to say.
No, I don't.
You're wearing a Ghostbuster shirt. It threw me off.
Threw you right off.
Your flannel matches your headphones, which matches your t-shirt.
Yeah, it's all, I'm coordinating.
Too bad you can't see what he looks like. But yeah, honestly, the IJ ladies, anytime I'm doing a Periscope, anytime, they're always there. So thank you a lot to you guys. And of course, all the, US FLD, not FLD, US PBR fans as well. No, that was just a Freudian slip.
DerekD.com, everybody.
Yeah, that's right. By the way, it's going to be very new lately with a lot of new pictures.
Oh, good. Soon. Good. Yeah. A big air hug goes out to Celeste. She's our latest.
We met her.
Yeah, we did. We took a picture with her at 60%.
Radio City.
Everybody, Franki, the producer. Hey, Franki.
Hi.
So Celeste is one of our newest sponsors on Patreon. Thank you so much for supporting patreon.com. You can get to the link for our show up there. You get extra content, which we've been hammering out pretty good. I stopped putting up our full episodes up there, and I've just been putting up the pregame or stuff that needs to be cut to Patreon. So
I think it's better that way because it gives them like stuff that obviously we wouldn't put in the show. They get to hear. It's like behind the scenes to only
premium
a select
content.
Few. Yeah. Yeah, you guys rock my socks.
Yeah, so you can check that out off of our website if you want to hear the behind-the-scenes stuff and special, just any. Sometimes I'm on set at IJ, and I'll just start recording with people, and I'll throw that up there, or Derek D riding on the train, or at FLD, or whatever, or Dennis, I don't know, watching TV.
Yeah.
So you get all kinds of weird stuff up there, and we're continue to put more stuff up there. We're going to make some special announcements up there coming up soon. I also want to quickly... Our sponsors, our basic sponsors that are on the show, House of Independence, Gianni's Pizzeria, Red Summit Productions. We want to thank them as well for helping us out. GoPro. So thank you.
Thank you.
There's a lot of thanking going on right now.
Yes. I mean, it's a very lovely episode right here.
There is no guest for this episode, but the four of us are here. Dennis and Franki, as well as Derek and I. But I do want to talk about what we have coming up, because there's some kick-ass stuff coming up that I'm super excited about,
oh,
man.
Oh, my God.
mainly some of our future guests. Just these two little names that we're going to be putting up episodes to, Brian Quinn and James Murray, but that's really not what I'm too excited about. Let's get to the exciting stuff. We're going to have Mini Kiss on the show.
And for those of you who don't know what that is, it's not me giving any of us giving someone a kiss, really tiny kiss.
Damn it.
It's actually small people, little people.
Little people.
Little people. You're not supposed to say midgets.
No.
But there's four of them. Four or five.
I believe there's four. You've heard of Kiss, right?
Four.
There's four people.
Yeah.
Can you name the original four in Kiss? Not Mini Kiss, but the original four.
Gene Simmons, yes. Paul Stanley. Yes. The one guy lives around
Peter Chris
around here, who we're actually trying to get on the show.
Awesome.
And then who's the fourth? You're missing
yeah,
one.
Yeah, I can't remember.
Paul Stanley.
No, I said that already.
No, said that already, man. Thanks for showing up.
Yeah, well, Dennis, listen.
His name is Ace Frehley.
Ace Frehley, yeah. Yes.
That's not his real name, but.
The crazy thing is, though, these little people dress up like Kiss, and they actually play instruments, and they are a Kiss cover band, but they're all little people, and they're we're going to have them on the show.
Very excited about that one, man. Very excited. Also, this
are they
one,
coming in the paint?
Oh, I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm not sure. Frank, first of all, we're not getting all four of them, right?
No, they have one who usually does interviews and shows like this, but you know it will be a day they are all performing at House of Independence.
Do you know which one? Is he the equivalent of the guy that plays Gene Simmons or Paul Stanley?
I don't know yet which one we're going to get. So, but I do think they will be in full makeup.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, I'm hoping that one's at House of Independence. So if you saw if you listened to our last episode of House of Independence, you could see, if you watched it on YouTube, the theater in the background. It's pretty awesome. So we'll be there again. And then this one, just like, I'm a total fanboy, man. Scotty from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy's going to be on the show.
That's huge.
If you don't know who Big Bad Voodoo Daddy is, I don't know. Just turn this off right now.
Yeah, they were made.
Turn this off. Go listen to Britney Spears.
They're made.
Go
world,
to DerekD.com.
Very Dennis, popular
shut the
in
fuck
the movie.
Up. I'm trying to talk.
Jordan, you can just mute him. You can have that.
I should just mute him, right?
What's your favorite song with Big Bad Voodoo Daddies?
I mean, anything from the first album, but like, you know, the Swinger soundtrack, Go Daddy-O, You and Me and the Bottle Makes Three Tonight, like all of those.
I think I saw them at Warped Tour one year.
I used to follow them in college. Like, that was the wheelhouse as to when they were big. I was in college. Yeah. Swingers had just come out, you know?
You're beautiful, baby. You're beautiful.
And they were in that movie. That's where they got their...
Oh, that's right. They are.
That's where they got their start from.
That's where they got their break.
And I used to go to... I saw them many times in Atlantic City. I saw them in Philadelphia. I saw them at BB King's in New York City. Like, I've seen them all up and down the East Coast. And one time, I hung out with them in the... I think it was like the Trump Taj Mahal or Harris Casino.
Let me tell you something. You're not allowed ever... In my hotel, Mike. You come in there, you're an idiot.
I don't know. Dennis, the intern, just wrote something on a piece of paper. And I have no
idea. Dennis, you're an idiot. Get out of here.
It was the marina. We were at the marina. They were playing, and we hung out with them. And they were really cool, man, and they didn't have to hang out with us.
All I heard was, blah, 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 I'm an idiot. It was fantastically stupid.
You know what's really stupid is that you're going to win the Republican nomination.
I already knew it.
It's unbelievable.
Knew it when I was five.
How do you feel? Like, I mean, this other candidate... Rubio is like, he's
who, Jeb Bush? He's an idiot.
No, he's out of the race. He's out of the race.
Go to JebBush.com. Takes you to me. Why? Because Trump.
Yeah, you were getting a little beat up at the last debate.
You know what? You're an idiot.
We know that, but Ted Cruz isn't even American. How come you're letting him like run for president?
Let me tell you something about Ted Cruz. His name, he's trying to be Tom Cruise, but he's way too ugly. He looks like Penguin from Batman.
He does. No, he looks like the grandfather from the Munsters.
That too.
Like Grandpa Munster?
He looks like Grandpa Munster.
Let me tell you something.
Hair.
We're going to make America great again with a great wall of Mexican China.
Now, the president of Mexico said that he, and this is a quote, I will not pay for that effing wall. How do you feel about that, Don?
Funny thing was, that guy's a puppet. I had my hand so far up his ass, I was making him say that to give me good press.
That's not good press, though. It's bad press.
Hola, ¿cómo estás, bitches?
And the crazy thing is, Dennis, you know how like when you win the presidency, you usually have like a band play. Right?
Yeah.
At your inauguration.
At your inauguration.
Yeah. I heard Donald's going to have Bruce Springsteen play.
Oh, I think that's a great choice.
Right?
Born in the USA.
Don, how did you meet Bruce?
Let me tell you something. I used to play guitar, and I'm just as good as anyone out there. Bruce was trying to open for me because I'm fantastic, and... this concert was going to be huge, and that's how I met him.
Bruce, is that true?
He sucked.
Well, you know, down on the streets of the Jersey Shore in Asbury Park, I came across this man, Trump, and, you know, I came up with that that one lyric.
You have one line of dialogue for Bruce.
The screen door slam. It's a Mary's dress with...
Hey, don't mess with the winning formula.
I mean, every time Derek goes into Bruce Springsteen, it's always one line of dialogue down on the street. Then when you try to like call him out on it, he just starts singing lyrics.
That's it.
You know?
Don't mess with a winning formula.
Is it winning?
I think it is.
I love Jersey and I love DerekD.com.
Look at Frankie's face. That is not the face you want to be looking at.
That was a crazy. Did you watch the Republic?
Did you see her face?
Yeah, I saw it.
It was pure misery.
She's like, tell you something, Franki, you're an idiot.
She's like, there are so many other places I could be right now. And I'm
why am I here?
Right,
Franki, I love you. I'm sorry.
A little bit.
But did you watch the most recent Republican debate? It was fireworks on the stage.
Dude, I've been paying attention, and I gotta be dead serious. It's terrifying.
It is. You know what? Trump could easily just sip and be like, okay, I'm putting on the, like, I'm going to be great. I'm great. I've done so many great things and you know, whatever. But, like, be a little more – now you're in this, dude. Like, be a little more presidential about it, just whether you like the guy or not.
He said he wanted to punch a protester in the face.
Like, how great would it be if he went up there? He's like, I know I've been a little way too cocky and everything, but I am here – to make America great. Like, if you just, it's way too bravado. Way too much bravado.
Too much.
Way too much, like, I did this, I did that, I did it. You're an idiot. You're an idiot. I mean, it's just, it's crazy.
It's scary because it's a circus. Like, there, and he's sucked in the other two candidates into his circus. You know what I mean? So there's nothing positive happening. They're just a bunch of idiots. No one can even.
And Ben Carson was over there. He's like, does someone want to attack me? He said that. I was cracking up. I was like, this guy's great.
But, like, no one can even get an opinion out.
No.
Yeah.
Like, no one can say, well, what do you want to do? And, you know, Trump's, his big answer is, you know, I'm going to do this and it's going to be great and America's going to be great, USA. And then and that's the same answer he's given to just about every question he's been asked. Like, what's your plan for healthcare? America's amazing and I'm going to make America great again.
Right.
It's like, well,
you know who else used to say that? Not America, but Germany.
Yeah, there's a lot of parallels there.
I mean, you know, that's what he used to say. Hitler used to say that.
We can't compare him to that. I mean, come on.
I have two theories. Number one is that this could be really brilliant, right? Tell me what you think about this.
Can't wait.
Number one is
60%
that
not brilliant.
He is in the running. Donald Trump is in the race because he's on the side of the Clintons. And he's doing this strategically to destroy the Republican Party so the Clinton wins.
So Mike Polano's...
That's one theory.
That's one conspiracy theory.
That's one, because, you know, he's given a ton of money to the Clintons, Bill Clinton's presidency.
Bill Clinton's presidency was pretty good, though.
Yeah, it was a good presidency.
I'm just telling you, that's where Donald Trump put his money. So, you know, there's a relationship there. And he's making a complete mockery, is he not? Like, listen, right now, if I had to vote, I'd vote for Donald Trump. But I'm saying he's making a mockery. I think he's going to bail out at the last minute, and then Clinton wins. Number two.
Oh, we can't have that.
That could happen. My second theory is that he's a member of ISIS.
Oh, my God.
That's the most... You're an idiot. I mean, come on.
Jesus. He's a member of ISIS and he's trying to destroy the country.
Trying to destroy America.
He's the sleeperest sleeper cell of all time.
He's just been laying in wait, masquerading as a real estate magnate.
He's a ginger, so he has superpowers. That's number one, right? He's a redheaded ginger ISIS. He's
orange. Like, I don't know.
As has been
foretold. I really don't know what's going on.
He is the largest Oompa Loompa. This is a fact.
Yeah,
ever graced the presidential stage.
We'll ask Tiny Kiss about that.
No, we won't.
We won't?
Okay, maybe we will.
Maybe we will.
Do you have a theories about it?
About this presidency?
Yeah.
I think that people are so used to voting for who they like to sing and, you know, what, you know, like all the stuff on TV.
Yeah, that's a good way to look at
it. They keep thinking that they're voting for, like, the next pop idol rather than the next president of the United States.
Yeah, that's a good point. Let's get a woman's perspective, Frank.
On the presidential election?
Sure.
I think it's scary.
Nobody cares.
It is.
Nobody cares what women think. Okay, so... listen, that was a bad joke. I'm sorry.
Terrible.
Look, my hands are here. No mute button.
I'm leaving the table now.
No, come on. What do you think? It's scary, you were saying?
One more time, and I'm leaving the show.
No!
Oh, that's... Can you get Dennis to leave the show?
We would have if we lost Franki, this show would be done.
There's no more show.
There's no more show.
It's over.
Do you agree with that?
I just said there's no more show. I 100% agree. I said that at the top of the show. At one of the intros.
One of the intros. Yeah, we did a few.
Not this one.
Patreon, you're going to get like six intros. But seriously, Frank, are you, because you're a woman, do you innately go to Hillary?
No. I have always considered myself a Democrat, but that is also changing. And I'm afraid. That's all I can say. Yeah, I'm afraid. And they did a poll recently to say, it's becoming clear that Trump will most likely be the nomination. And how do people feel? And 51%. The answer was afraid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yet they're all voting.
Exactly. So it's interesting. And you go down the list, like afraid, shocked, excited about it. The percentages get lower as you go down in this recent poll that I just happened to catch on the news. But
I mean, it's very interesting and scary. But at the same time, I guess you could look at it sort of like okay, he's way too overly conceited and all that shit, but like, you know, he is a very good businessman, and our economy is in the crapper. Maybe that's, you know.
That's arguable, though, right? Because how many, I feel like Dennis will know the answer to this.
Yeah, but you're going to bring up the bankruptcy.
Well, how many bankruptcies has he had?
But that's almost irrelevant.
He's had a couple.
But that's
that's like his exit plan.
That's like a regular, like a lot of businessmen do that, I guess, in certain situations.
Right, he's still, as a strategic move.
Yeah, he admitted it.
A lot of people think that, I think a lot of people are starting to feel like, wow, he might be the guy to do it, to take control or to, you know, straighten out the country and all that stuff. But they say there's too many people in America that want the handout so that he could never win, really. I don't know, though, that they would vote for Hillary. I don't know that those people, there's, you know, honestly, say Democrats or whatever, or people who want more of the handouts, more of the...
The biggest problem with Hillary, she's like a cardboard cutout of a person. Like every time you're talking to her, it's like a billboard.
Yeah. I honestly think Hillary would be worse than Trump.
She'll be so bad for the country. You know, I think everybody's terrified.
Just to your point, though, Dennis, I think for a woman to be in power, they have to take away their personality to be taken seriously, where a guy has to be more charismatic, more likable, more charming.
There's nothing.
I'm all for a woman being president.
Yeah, of course.
Just not Hillary.
Yeah, there's nothing likable about it at all.
I don't know if I agree with that, because I think Fiorina, although I didn't think she was going to get the nomination, I found her to be very compelling to watch. And I thought that everything that she said was ingratiating and honest. I just feel like Hillary is she's just so prepped. I guess that's the only way.
They
I
said
think
she
of.
Dresses like Kim Jong Un. Those comparisons. Yeah,
right.
I don't think it's lack of personality.
I know what you're saying. I just think that if a woman were to show femininity, that would not necessarily help her campaign. In the end, I don't think people would say that this person can run our country.
Name a woman you think would be a good president that you can think of.
Oh, that's so easy. Sydney L'Esperance.
Cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
But she's not old enough.
Yeah. She's not yet.
Roseanne Barr.
Sofia Vergara. Oh wait, she's she can't be. She's not born here.
Ming Chen. She'd be amazing.
would be something.
We have a huge, according to our numbers and our social media, we have a huge following in England, London, maybe the Europe of all regions.
Yes.
732-759-0378. Who do you think would be? What do you think about the American presidential election? That's what I want to know.
What was that number? 732-759-0378.
You can find that right at the top of our webpage.
Yeah, and you can call and leave a voicemail.
Did you see that clip where Canada wants to run for president of the United States?
That's awesome.
The country of Canada wants to be our president.
we're in trouble, man. I don't even know.
Like I said, it's a circus. And again, people are voting for people they think they want to have a beer with rather than someone who could lead a country.
So back to what we were actually talking about, some of the future guests coming up on
the
show.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
We talked about
Brian Quinn
and James Murray. We talked about Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
Yeah.
We didn't talk about this, and maybe this person can shed some light on the election, because he can see the future, guys. The amazing Kreskin is going to be on PBR.
He knew you were going to say that.
He did.
He's been around, man. He's old.
Yeah, man.
He's been around forever.
His Twitter tag says, even now, I know what you're thinking.
How many followers does he have?
Oh, I don't know. He knows, though.
He knows.
Not only does he know how many he has, he knows who's going to follow him in the future.
And you know that one guy out there listening who wants to drop him? He knows you're going to do that, too.
He's like, it doesn't matter. I may only have 2,500 Twitter followers now, but I'm going to have 250,000 Twitter followers
by April 14th.
So the amazing Kreskin, you might know him from all of the late night talk shows. He's a how did you describe him?
He's like a futurist.
He's
like
a what is well, that?
Not
mean?
A, but he's a magician.
He's like a magician,
comedian,
mentalist. You know, he's just all around spooky guy. He's just one of those guys that can just look at you. And already he's like, yeah, okay, I know everything I need to know.
And he's in his late 70s, right, man? He's definitely going to be the oldest guest.
I'm not
guest.
Too familiar, if I'm being honest.
Well, you're going to have to do some research for that.
Well, I will.
And then somebody you are familiar with, DerekD.com, is Jeffrey Gurian.
Yeah, Jeffrey Gurian.
Yeah, so
guy is a trip.
Talk to me about this guy, because people are going to see him on our website. And he's not, like, well-known by name, but if you saw him, you'd know who he is.
Yeah, well, no, you might not. I mean, this guy, he was a dentist. And then he just started following comedy. And he knows every big comic, whether he knows them personally or just hang out with
he's hung done out their with fillings. Them.
Every, you know, he's not even a dentist anymore. But he's been rocking the same style since the 70s, this guy. His hair, the scarf, the glasses. He knows every you name it. He wrote a book. He has a he has his own show on YouTube, and yeah, he is a trip. I shot a bit with him for that he directed. It was called like Besame Mucho or something. It was most ridiculous. My friend Lauren. But anyway, Jeffrey Gurian is a character, and it'd be great to be on the show. Like, the dude's nice. A trip. And like, you're not a comedian unless you know who Jeffrey Gurian is.
Right on.
So I'm glad I'm in that category.
Yeah, well, we went to see the Jokers at like, Radio Jeffrey. City Music Hall. He was there. We were hanging out in the back room, and we were talking to Lisa Lampanelli, who Gatto's good friends with. So yeah. we might have her on the show as well. You know, Jeffrey had so many stories to tell, and he seemed like such a wealth of like he's been in the New York comedy scene, like you said, forever. The stories we're going to dig out of him are going to be amazing, right?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, he's still...
Root canal and comedy.
Yeah. Well said. I don't know how funny he is doing stand-up. I never saw him do stand-up, but he knows all these guys. So yeah, just check out... Look up Jeffrey Gurian and look at his hair.
It's he's right on the front of our website. You can click on him. It'll go
That's
to
That's pbrpodcast.com.
Wow.
Thank you, DerekD.com.
This just in, literally, from our producer, Franki, and I have so many ideas for this episode, but you, a former... Lightweight, 155-pound champion, UFC champion, Franki Edgar, is going to be on PBR Podcast.
Really?
Oh!
Nice. That's awesome. That's right up your
Fist
alley.
Yeah. So, one of the first thing that comes to my mind is, can we get him to wrestle Dennis the Intern?
Yeah. Choke me out.
I mean, there's room in the studio, right?
Yeah, we can do something. We'll set up a ring.
I mean, you must outweigh Franki Edgar. He's 155 pounds. So
yeah, it's like my leg.
Dennis the Intern has to wear a lucha.
Oh my God, that's so brilliant, dude.
Speaking of, that's going to be at the House of Independence. There's going to be boxing and
the luchadors.
And we'll be there. Yeah. We're going to that one, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm going to get hurt.
So that's exciting, guys. We have a lot of like what I consider an eclectic bunch of people, and that's going to be fun, man. All of those are going to be so different and so amazing at the same time.
Oh, dude. It's going to be awesome.
So thank you, everyone, for listening to the shows and making these guests possible, because really, they're not possible without the listeners, right?
Exactly. What would we be doing? We would be talking to ourselves. We'd be talking to each other.
Oh, man. There's that sexy music, everybody. Franki, you're going to sit in for this one, right? All right, you're going to talk into the microphone so people can hear you?
You have me muted.
You're not muted? Way to Mike bring, the, way to bring the show down. Oh, my God. Derek, good idea letting her sit in.
What are you talking about?
Did my
headphones just get lower?
They might have got it. I'm playing a little bit. Oh. There's the funky music, top or bottom. We all know how this game's played. I'm going to give two terms, this or that, a yin or yang, a peanut butter or jelly. If these two things are a relationship, which one will be on the top? Which one will be on the bottom? Dennis, you ready to play?
I'm ready to play.
All right, Franki, we're going to start with you.
Oh, boy.
Top or bottom, number one, fact checkers or interns?
That's not uncomfortable at all.
Before we even get into that, can we, everybody, go out and follow Sid the Fact Checker.
Get her.
Right? Yeah.
She's great.
She listens to our episode, Sydney Lesperance. She's our fact checker. She listens, finds what we did that was wrong, which is about 60% of everything we say, and she tweets it out. And we
is
retweet
she from
it.
The UK?
No.
She's not. She's from
Minnesota.
Michigan.
Minnesota.
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 She's, wherever she's from, they don't have beaches.
They don't have beaches.
No, no beaches.
Son of a beach.
Fact checkers on top, of course.
Wow, he sits right next to
me. Right here. Oh,
well, that's Frankie's thing. You know, Franki looks stuff up, too.
Oh, I'm going to go with interns. Yay me.
How? Like, at what age is it not cool to be an intern anymore?
Dude? I don't know. As soon as I have to move out of my parents' house.
You're like Greg T, the frat boy from, like,
That is, I'm in good company.
You know, I'm going to say interns on top, but not for Dennis, because I've had interns in the past, and they were great. I mean, he's... But interns on top. Dennis, yeah.
Celebrating mediocrity.
I'm going to disagree with that, man. I'm going to go with fact checkers on top. I'm #TeamSid. You know, like, how often do you have somebody just checking all of the shit you say for facts, for, you know, factualness? I just said factualness, by the
factualness,
way.
Factualness, check that out.
Sydney LaFrance.
Cha-ching.
Is that a word? Fact check that.
Not that often, but I mean, I have all the the keyboard warriors every day on my show being like, oh, Doug, you said this right.
You said it was going to be 3.4
everything.
Seconds.
Right, so everything. You're saying the fact checkers that are trolling.
Critical.
Yeah.
No, she's Sydney's not a troll.
No, we're not saying that.
She's amazing.
She's part of as much of the show as you are, you intern.
You intern.
Oh, top or bottom, number two, mixed results or Menergize.
Come on. Menergize doesn't even exist.
Some things will never die.
Ever.
For the Derek D, Menergize. No, mixed what? Results.
Mixed results,
mixed
Frank.
Mixed results on top. Mixed results.
I just...
Frosted tips, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, frosted tips.
Frosted tips, we're going to go with, it's got to be Menergize. That's like the greatest boy band name well,
that,
ever.
But Mike made that up.
I did not make it up, but I will not reveal where I stole it from. I guess I should, though, at some point.
I'm going mixed results on top. And Menergize on the bottom.
I'm going to say, I'm going to, you know, you might be a little surprised. I'm going to go with mixed results with a Z. Because
nice.
It just provides us with so much
what?
Comedy to make fun of Derek.
But the comedy's in Menergize.
You know what? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to, you know what? I'm going to make an announcement right now. This is big.
Oh, here it is.
Drum roll.
Press conference.
Music out.
You got to, okay. I'm going to give Mike a clip of me on mixed results to put that up on PBR podcast or wherever.
Christmas came early.
You guys can
Patreon
finally
first.
Patreon first.
Put it up for our Patreon supporters.
It's actually like an 8-minute clip, but we'll just have to take one.
Edit that.
And the video quality sucks, but it's nowhere online.
Can we do one better?
Sure. Right?
All right. Can we Mystery Science Theater 2000 it?
Oh my God, Mike, you're my favorite person of all time.
Yes, whatever you'd like to do.
So do you know what that is?
Maybe if there's some sort of pod festival, we could show it there.
Well, don't spill that beans yet. Do you know what that is? So
yeah.
We'll play it on the screen, and the four of us will sit there, and it'll be an over-the-shoulder shot, and we'll commentate as it's playing.
Oh my God.
Is that something you want to see?
That could be, we could do something. There's also, I have the footage from Say What Karaoke, but that was only the three of us. This is actually straight up mixed
ladies
results.
And gentlemen, this is coming
this
to
is
Patreon.
Big. Yes. This is big.
Give me a month. This is in the next month. This is coming to Patreon. So you got time to go sign up.
I have to
start watching old episodes of Mystery Science 3000. Get my chops back. This
wasn't even planned.
I
just set out with it because the top and bottom.
Frankie, write this down because we'll forget. Top or bottom number three.
Mixed results.
What's
clip.
In the box? Or Esther.
Well, that's tough because I do love to see you guys act out different characters and sweat a little when you don't know the political topics that we're talking about. You know, you're not up on your current events, but the box is my box and I love it and I love the way it looks and it's our branding, so I'm going what's in the box.
Okay.
The
Dennis the intern.
I'm going to say I like what's in the box and just leave it right there.
Well, you know, I like Asta because, you know, acting and it's fun and you can play someone else and do impersonations. But what's in the box is great, too, because it's that mystery of what's in the box. But that's on the bottom.
Oh, dear, right?
Boxes are usually on the bottom.
I like what you did there. Mm-hmm. He brought in that other game, the one we're playing now. Top or bottom?
Top or bottom.
I'm going to say what's in the box because I just like to say that.
Yeah.
I find that game... I don't know. I really would like to ask the listeners, like, which game do they find more entertaining, really? Because sometimes what's in the box, I feel like, to me, while we're recording it, I'm going, wow, this is, like, slow. But I know that people are listening, and they're guessing themselves.
Because they're trying to figure it out.
And they're trying to figure it out, and they like that. And ask the, again, because of the personalities, I don't know how, what's in the box, clearly.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let me ask something. What do you think do you remember what your best impression was on Asta? What do you do?
There were a couple that I nailed. Do you have one in mind that I did?
I'm trying to think. I was trying to think of one.
When I did Down by the River.
Oh, Chris Farley.
Yeah, I thought I kind of nailed that.
In the van down by the river.
We were up at Fastlane Daily. Who was our guest on that episode? I believe Gatto was there.
It had to be
Colin Jost.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
What about the staff?
But do you have an impression
and
you
do
that
nail
you
it.
Think?
That was an excellent.
I nailed it, right?
You did. You nailed
which
it.
Which one?
It was great.
The Farley.
Farley.
Yeah, Chris Farley.
So he just became.
Would you say that's your best impression that you could do?
No, I think I did.
I'm having a memory
just
of
in
you
general.
Doing Macho Man when we were at the brewery.
I was going to say wrestlers, yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
We were at the brewery in Staten Island.
Yeah. Notice how I'm not jumping into any of them right now.
No, no.
Right? Because I'm not a monkey, guys. Okay? I'm not a monkey. My name's Mike.
Mike the Monkey.
I ride a bike. Sometimes a trike.
You should just start rhyming over this
no,
this music.
I can't rhyme over this. It's like the salsa beat.
Yeah, it's actually...
Hi, puppy.
Yeah, it'd be very fast.
We are going to do it. It has been recommended that we do an episode with Sahari Candela in Miami, and that this would be appropriate for that, but that has not been set up yet.
Interesting.
Top or bottom number four. Pick one. We or they? No? You guys looking at the script?
I am.
Pick which one you want to do, 1, 2, 3, or 4.
I like the second one.
Top or bottom, the speakeasy or on location?
Well, visually, I think the on location ones look better. And I enjoy, you know, putting those episodes out for our guests. But, you know, I like being in our home studio.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. I have to decide, though, right?
Yes.
I mean, that's why we play the game top or bottom.
All right.
It's really not that interesting if you just say...
say you like everything.
Can't everybody just win?
Hashtag mushrooms.
Speakeasy on top.
Speakeasy on the top.
You like it, huh, Dennis? Why? Because you got to lug everything?
Because I got to take everything and set it up. But this is it, man. We got the bar. We got the room. This is our spot. This is our place.
As much as I don't want to agree with that, I kind of agree with that.
Why do you want to agree with that?
Do you not want to agree with it just because it's him?
Because yeah. Dennis said it.
So I'm going to say I agree with Franki.
But not Dennis? Not Dennis.
I like it.
Yeah, not Dennis. I do.
But he said the same thing that she said.
It wasn't done in the tone that I approve of.
Exactly.
So and he was referring it to it was his, and I didn't like that because it's not yours, Dennis. Right. It's ours.
I think I said ours.
Whatever. All I heard was blah blah blah. I'm an idiot. So yeah, I don't know. I really do like the on location spots too, but home base is home base. Top. Speakeasy.
Yeah.
Dennis, we told you to walk the dog earlier. Jeez.
I don't know, man. I'm contemplating it, you know? I let it breathe for a second.
You're mulling it.
I hate on location while we're doing it, but I love it. I hate on location before we start. Once we start, I love it.
Yeah, because of the prep and everything like that.
A lot of prep. You know, this studio doesn't, it's not like we're recording on a little HM4 handheld. Like, we're in a legit studio that has to be broken down and set up and transported. And mm-hmm. I remember one time we were going on location to, as a matter of fact, this episode's going to be airing soon. We were going to James Murray's house from the Impractical Jokers fame. And I just picked up Franki, and we were pulling out of a driveway. And we had actually, this is something that you won't probably see, maybe a clip of it, but we rigged the car. You remember, we rigged the car with all of the equipment, and we did an on-the-road episode.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So we had all of the road to nowhere. We had all of the cases in the back of the truck. Empty, though, because everything was set up in the car.
Uh-huh.
And we pulled out onto the highway, and I gassed it, and the back door opened, and all of our cases and got hit by a bus. And it could have been so detrimental. Like, all of this equipment could have been destroyed, but it was just some plastic Tupperware, and we lost a Yeti mic. You know,
it happens.
So, I mean, I don't love that part of it. You know what I mean? But the episode with James was great.
And that doesn't happen every time.
You'll be hearing that in probably like 2 weeks, depending on when you're listening to this episode.
Yeah.
Top or bottom, number 5, past guests or future guests?
I didn't know I was going to be doing this when I wrote the scripts.
Why does it make it any different?
Because I think this one is tough, and I was very curious to see what you guys would have to say about it. I love our past guests, but the future is bright for PBR, so I'm going to say future guests on top.
Oh, man.
Hmm.
This is a tough one because, you know, we don't get to the future without building a good base. Can I say both?
No, you can't. I mean,
I'm going to say looking forward, the future.
Interesting. Dennis kind of alluded to what I was going to say. I was going to say our past guests kind of built our foundation, you know, like what... You know, we have to go through all that to get to here and to move forward into the future. So, that being said, I should be the president of the United States. that being said, I'm going to go past on top, future on the bottom, but very much looking forward to the future.
Oh, like, hands down, right?
It's a warm bottom.
Like, think about it. Like, think about a TV show or something when it started. You know, that's the beginning.
Oh.
What's happening?
This is my answer.
This is his answer right here.
BBDD.
Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
Oh.
Are you kidding me, man? We got Big Bad Voodoo Daddy coming on.
That's right.
We got Mini Kiss.
We got Mini Kiss. We got midget small people.
Oh, I can't wait, dude. The past guests were great, but the future guests are going to be so great, and they just keep getting greater.
They just keep getting better.
And you know what the best part about
it
is?
Gonna be?
I think Kreskin knew I was going to say that.
Yes. He probably did.
So this is a little BBVD. We're going to have them on. Scotty.
What is the underwear? Isn't it BVDs and underwear?
Yeah. But this is Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
BBVD. What's that stand for?
Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
No, BVDs.
Big Bad Voodoo.
No.
Bad Voodoo Daddy.
That'd be bad. BVDs, the underwear, what does that stand for? Briefs?
You know, there's one way to find out. That's so easy.
Sid the fact checker.
Cha-ching.
I mean, I could look it up on my phone right now, but I'm not going to. I'm going to wait till she
That's why we have
it.
Fact checkers, man.
100%.
Oh, that's great. So top or bottom, everybody. Good job.
Hey!
Nice outro.
That's how it goes, man. You've been around.
Yes.
So what else is up on the docket? We've talked about politics. We've talked about top or bottom. We've talked about our guest list. It's pretty exciting. Franki, what's up on the docket?
I think we should go right to our listeners. All right. We got a lot of content there.
Oh, yeah.
We got some great messages, some good questions,
Ooh. Some
requests for you boys.
Yeah, and you guys haven't heard these yet. We put it out there to our listeners. This episode is really... Oh, we got a new one that just came in, too. We put it out there to the listeners. This episode is just us, no guests. We wanted to hear from them. We've done this before, and it seems to be great. And
we're our stars in our own right.
Well, you know, DerekD.com, everybody.
No, I said we. I said we, as in me, you, Franki.
Yeah. But once in a while, it's nice to thank the listeners, the people that give us all that love out there on the social media and... Buy those t-shirts 100%. And sport them.
Yeah. Love it. And they're always...
So they're really our guests this episode. Now, this is about taking stock and thanking them and letting them be let them have the forefront, the spotlight for a little while.
Fans are the guests.
I mean, we end the show, give us some love, and we'll love you back. And this is us loving you back. And I got, you know, before we do get into that, you mentioned the t-shirts and the hats and everything. I got to be honest with you, man. Seeing everybody send us pictures or tweet out pictures in our gear, our swag
is unbelievable.
You know what I'm saying? Do you love that?
I think it's amazing. They always, anytime they get a t-shirt or something, or anytime they're wearing it, they tweet it, they take a picture, and send it. It's awesome.
Thank you so much for that.
You guys are giving us marketing, and it's great. Thank you so much.
We do have some new product coming out. It's being made now. You'll see it up on the store coming up probably in a month or two. I think we're going to rock the Keep Common Call Dennis t-shirt.
Yeah!
That one's getting made. We have another rendition of our PBR t-shirt, which Derek is designing as we speak, so I don't know what it looks like yet. And then... I think we're going baseball hats, trucker hats with a patch.
The mesh?
Yeah. Little snapbacks?
Snapbacks. Is that what you call them?
Yeah.
With the patch, our PBR logo.
That'd be amazing.
Those are coming soon. Look for the, out on our store for that, and we'll tweet it out. But if you guys want anything, let us know what you want.
That would be huge.
All right, so Franki, help me out with these. I'm going to play them. I don't know who they're coming from unless they say it in the message. You've kind of paid attention to this more than me. So here we go. Here's number one. First voice mail.
Hi boys, it's Gail,
Charlie,
and Vicky
from IJ Ladies. We had to ring you, didn't we?
We had to definitely
ring us.
We're just saying hi from London. As you know, we're in London watching
London, baby.
The Impractical Jokers this weekend. We're having a whale of a time. I've already kissed Murray, so that's good.
Gross.
We met your boy Joe.
Yeah, we met your boy Joe.
Dressing the PBR, we wear in our t-shirt.
Yeah,
who did we?
Thank you.
He was very, very impressed. We love you guys, you know we love you, and I suppose our question is, when are you getting your butts over to London, because we want to hang out.
Yeah,
we'll buy your beers. Get your bums on planes.
Definitely.
Love you guys. See you soon. Bye.
That's so great, man. Thank you. You know, so glad I played that one first, because that speaks to like everything we were just talking about. You know what I mean? They met the Jokers are in London right now, and they met them, and they were wearing their PBR gear. Which is awesome. And they kiss Murray, which is gross. That's not awesome. They should probably go to a doctor immediately.
Get that checked.
And yes, Gatto is the man. But they asked the question, when are you guys going over to London?
I don't know.
You do? I do.
When?
And I need to talk to you about this. Okay. Might as well talk about it on air
right now. Sure.
This is 60%.
Okay.
But Joker, can I say this? Can I talk about it?
Sure.
There's a show that I've been known to work on that may be shooting in London coming up over spring break. And I'm 60% of me is booked to go shoot in London on the show, which means I'll be in London, which means I could probably do, you know, there's another guy that's going to be there. You know, he'll be in London. There's only another guy that has to fly to London for the weekend to do a live podcast in London.
Who is that?
His name's DerekD.com.
Oh, it is. Is it his last name's Com?
I don't know. What do you think? Get on a plane, maybe? I mean,
I'll Uber a plane.
You Uber planes now?
I've been thinking about it, though.
In all seriousness, I would love to get out there.
At least do like a.
I have bachelor parties and weddings coming up. I got to fly a lot, so like, we just got to see what's doing. But
small pub somewhere, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I would
PBR
love to go.
Meet up.
What, go for like a long week, like Thursday to Sunday or something?
Well, you know, whatever you want to do. I'll be out there for a week filming, working, but I'm sure there's a night where we can maybe set up a live show. I don't know. I'm just putting it out there. We got some fans in London. I don't know.
Yeah, that'd be let's work on that. But I would love to get out there and see you guys. IJ Ladies, thank you so much. You guys rock.
And that picture's already up on Instagram, girl, so go take a look.
Hey, wasn't Dennis the Intern on their podcast?
Yes, I did their podcast a little while ago. It went great.
How'd that go?
I think it went really, really well. You know, thank you for having me.
It was. It was great.
Thank you.
All right, here's the next one. I have no, this is from, all I know is from Clearwater, Florida.
Is it clearly underwater in Florida?
No good. Go up to the next one.
In the meantime, I'd like to take the time to shout out Gianni's Pizza. It's delicious. All up, slice up your mouth. So delicious in your mouth. Gianni'sPizzeria.com. Head over there for all your delicious needs of subs and pizza with the most stringiest of cheese and the graviest of sauce.
Here we go.
The graviest.
Hey, guys. It's G at Gianastino. I hope you're all good. And I'm just calling to ask you a question. My question to you all is, if you could be any character from an 80s movie, who would it be and why? Okay, go for it. Hope you're all good. Have a great weekend and a great show. And speak to you soon. Take care. Bye.
I love the accents, man. I can't even tell you how much.
I love it. That's actually so sexy. It's like sensual.
It's unbelievable. I actually set my Siri to Australian.
Me too. Might as well.
Yeah.
That was from Gianastino.
Yeah.
Hey, Gianastino over here. Good to have you.
Why did you just kick into the Sopranos?
Gianastino, it's like
but she's English.
Hey, Gianastino.
Yeah, she's clearly not Italian.
Isn't that Bob Schumann Jr.?
No.
But that.
All right, so she has, first of all, thank you so much for calling in. And we love you, clearly.
Gianastino Pizzeria.
What she asked what 80s character we would be from a movie and why?
Yeah, I it's just Dennis for a second cuz I think he's going to say the same one as me.
Maybe. Go ahead.
Marty McFly.
Marty McFly.
That's it.
All right. Why?
He's the man. He gets that cool black truck, and his chick is hot, and he goes in the future and stuff. Has hoverboards.
And he's Old West.
He's Michael J. Fox. Doc.
Since Marty McFly is taken off the table, I'm going to go with, if I could be anybody, I would love, and not that I'm anywhere near it, but if I get to be them, it would be Ferris Bueller.
Oh, that's a good one, man.
Yeah.
The guy who played McDreamy, and Patrick Dempsey.
Can't Buy Me Love. Senior Pizza?
Can't Buy Me Love.
He was in a bunch of,
Yeah.
That was a great movie, too.
That was Loverboy, Senior Pizza, right?
Loverboy.
That was Loverboy.
Extra anchovies.
Yeah.
But You Can't Buy Me Love. That's a good one. You'd be good as that.
That'd be awesome. I would love to play that.
The Lawn Boy.
They need to do that again. They need to remake that with me.
Derek.com.
Jesus Christ. Frank.
I don't know. I think I'm going Molly Ringwald in 16
Candles. 16 Candles.
16 Candles. Was Misery an 80s movie?
Who would you be?
Kathy Bates?
He was such a dude. I hated him.
What?
Yeah. Or was Deliverance was in the 80s?
Deliverance was the 70s.
70s? Can we pretend it was in the
80s? No.
I want to be the kid on the bridge.
You want to be the banjo boy?
Yeah.
Wait, seriously. Who would... think 80s... That's very funny.
And, honestly, all joking aside, if I had to be anybody, I would be the Avenger from Toxic Avenger.
The only superhero from New Jersey.
That's right.
You'd be Michael Knight if it was
born
a TV show.
Booton.
Born in Booton. Really?
They shot that in Booton.
Driver Joe's from Booton. Yeah. Wow.
The Booton. His origin, when he jumps out of the health club, that was in Booton.
I also, all joking aside, from the greatest Christmas movie of all time. Die Hard.
That was in the 80s?
I'd be the black cop.
That wasn't early 90s?
You'd be Reginald Vell Johnson?
I'd be Reginald Vell
Johnson. I shot a kid.
or Mel Gibson, Lethal Weapon.
No. You got it all wrong. I wouldn't be Mel Gibson.
I'd be Danny Glover.
I want to be sitting on a toilet.
Mel Gibson was Riggs.
I'm getting too old for this shit.
What was his name
Murtaugh.
In the movie?
Murtaugh.
Yeah. Oh. But yeah, first choice is...
No. I changed my mind. Was Karate Kid in the
80s? Oh, yeah. You're Daniel...
No, Mr. Miyagi. Hands down.
I would have sworn you'd be Johnny. Be the leader of... Yeah, you'd be Johnny.
Put it in the body bag,
sweep
Johnny.
Sweep the leg.
All joking aside, if I had to be... If you really know me, there's one person in that movie that I clearly am.
The leader of Cobra Kai.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
What was his name again?
Cobra Kai.
Fear does not exist in this dojo.
This dojo.
Does it?
No, sensei! Pain does not exist in this dojo. Does it?
No, sensei!
Right?
Yeah.
Such a good movie. Here we go. Next one.
Hey, PBR. It's Michelle. I'm just calling in with a quick hello to my favorite group of podcasters. Just wanted to say, keep up with the amazing work. Love you guys. Talk to you soon. Bye. Hashtag eggs. Bye.
Wow.
What'd she say at the end?
Hashtag eggs.
Hashtag eggs. Don't exit too, Michelle. I was about to say we love you, but you threw eggs at us now. I don't love you.
No, eggs do not exist inside this dope show.
Thank you so much for that. We appreciate that. We
love
you.
Thank you, Michelle. Can I call you Shell?
I think you can call Shell.
Yeah, thank you, Michelle.
Right? She has
she goes by Shelly sometimes on there.
Clearly part of the PBR Posse.
Yep, absolutely. She's been a long-time fan.
It's good to have you. We love you.
She
love
coughed
you back.
Before she loved us, right? You heard that? Was that like, this is bullshit, what I'm about to say?
Or nervous. Or nervous. Like
overwhelmed?
Or nervous, like she's about to drop the L-bomb. I mean, that's a big step.
Right, because it's not like she just likes us. Like, we're not just holding hands. Like, we've gone to second base.
Yeah, we're easily touching boobs.
Right? No, stereo. Right, left ear.
No, I mean, second, one, in two. In a sense of a scale. What are you saying?
I'm not talking physical, sexual. Like, we've never met, but on a relationship, podcast to podcast listener, El Duce.
Yeah. All right, so everybody give her a little love. She's at Michelle Lee 28. That's Michelle with one L, Lee, L-E-I-G-H, 28. Michelle Lee on Twitter and Instagram. Give her some love.
That's kind of interesting.
Or eggs.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you know what? Hashtag eggs at her.
Yeah. She threw you know what's kind of funny? Her name's Michelle Lee, but it's like Michelle Lee. Like Shelly. Michelle Lee. But that's...
Oh, what? No, but she clearly said it's Michelle, right?
Her name is Michelle, but I think her nickname is Shelly. Yeah. She's used it before online.
And her middle name might be Lee, L-E-I-G-H.
All right, here we go.
Hi there, this is Donna from Ireland. I think you all know me as King Bruno Baratheon on Twitter. But firstly, I just want to say that I absolutely love the podcast and I think you guys are amazing. Really, really fantastic. But I do have a question for everybody. And it's, what is the one thing that you hated but everybody else loved and raved about? Mm. I also have a musical request, and it's for my favorite, Mike Pilano. Sing anything. Ugh. Anything. I just want to hear you sing again, Mike. Okay. Take care, guys. Thanks a million. Bye.
All right, first things
Mike
first.
Mike can't sing.
Wow. Wait, he's actually blushing right now. I just want to say that. He really is blushing.
First of all, I love her. I love her picture on social media with our Scully, our PBR Scully on. So thank you so much because... I love you as well. But I do want to point out that when you said that, Derek D got, he almost vomited. Like, he could get so mad if anybody else gets complimented.
I do.
Like, how does she dare not love the Derek D?
I do not. I do
did
not.
Did you all see it?
It was true or false?
Well, he's going to say butt right now. So
I
go ahead.
Do not. But it's true.
Yeah.
Oh my God, why, man?
It's really not that true.
Franki and I were here looking at Mike, just sharing in his feeling, and Derek's like, oh, I don't know what's wrong with me.
Like, what did I do wrong?
Derek still thinks we rigged that Twitter poll. Where 100%.
It was not rigged.
100% rigged. I'm not even going to talk about it.
Really, dude? So what are you doing?
Don't worry about it. I'm trying to relax.
Oh,
anyway,
God.
that was a very nice voicemail she left.
Yeah. So you're going to fulfill her request?
I mean, what was the request?
Well, she wanted you to sing something.
But
I
then
believe.
There was a question she had too.
Pressure. Oh, well, yeah. No, well, let's go with the question. Can we go with the question first? Go with the question first. I got to prepare over here.
All right. The question was, have you ever hated something that everybody else loved? You too. Have you ever hated something that everybody else loved and raved about?
I don't think so. I mean,
a lot of people like raisins. I hate raisins. Raisins ruin everything. Like little bugs and cookies, little
blowing
bugs and
the
muffins.
Lid off this.
Stupid raisins.
Raisins.
But not everyone loves raisins.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, I don't have that hipster ethic where I have to hate something that everybody likes. So I kind of like everything. So no.
Wait, was the question something that you...
Dennis, cop out. Dennis!
No, it's not a cop out.
Is it that something you love that everyone else hates or something you hate that...
I have
a very clear answer to that.
What?
Christmas.
You
oh, come on.
Christmas is the answer.
Hold on. You hate, not dislike it, you hate Christmas.
I hate Christmas.
Really?
Yeah. But I love Thanksgiving. I've always said since the dawn of time, if you ever listen to this podcast, we've talked about it on many holiday episodes. Christmas is like, Thanksgiving is Christmas without the bullshit of the gifts.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I love Thanksgiving. And I love the Thanksgiving aspects of Christmas, but I hate the Hallmark holiday. I think one of the girls from overseas asked what a Hallmark holiday is. And that's when...
It was her. I'm pretty sure it was her.
Yeah. It's something that is created by the card companies for us, like Valentine's Day, to spend more money.
Disagree.
I think it's BS, dude. I don't know if Christmas is a Hallmark holiday.
It's Hallmark.
Doesn't it mark the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ?
Maybe yours.
It's all what you make. I mean, I'm... if I got no gifts for Christmas, I still would love it. I love the holiday season. I love Thanksgiving too.
Yeah.
It's like an awesome game before the big game. Like the whole season I love.
So Thanksgiving is Christmas's tailgate.
Yes.
Yeah.
Good way to look at it. And the food is just as good, if not better. But I love Christmas. I'm a little kid. I'm a little kid when it comes. Just like when I go to Disney World, I turn into a little kid. Like, I love it.
Did you answer, Frank?
I did.
You did.
With this raisin?
What did you hate? Oh, Frankie.
Mustang salad.
Mustang salad.
Oh.
That wasn't me.
That's not Mike.
I thought I had an instrumental.
I guess you should have blown your Mustang down.
Oh, here we go. I need some backup in a second, everybody. This is for Bruno.
Whoa, Mustang Sally now, baby. I guess you should have slowed your Mustang down.
Oh, you guys didn't even know that I had it, did you?
No.
I'm going to mess up the words here, but I don't care. I'm going for it.
You've been running all over town. You could have slowed that Mustang down.
I don't know. I think I need the PBR Posse to jump in here for a little backup.
Because all I want to do is ride around Sally.
Ride, Sally, ride.
That's all I got. Take it over, Derek D.
All you want to do is ride around Sally.
I thought it was the next part.
Ride, Sally, ride.
I love how we both went high.
I'll go low.
You go low?
I'll go low.
Ride around Sally.
Ride, Sally, ride.
Wanna be early mornings. I'm gonna be your weeping eyes.
I thought I knew all the words. I guess we don't.
I think if you grumble a lot, you'd get most of them.
I don't know. I think I did fairly well.
Oh, I wish the listeners could have seen it.
That was a good...
You were in. You had mic work.
In. You had that good, like...
Yeah.
So there you go.
Next
message.
You started like Ray Charles.
I don't even know what just happened.
Swinging it.
I really wish I had more time to prepare for that. I would have pulled up an instrumental version so you could have just heard it all.
You could have had a karaoke version instead of the words.
That's when they pay you the big bucks.
See that? <Yeah. laughs>
Here we go.
This is Celeste.
Hold on a sec. Hold on, Celeste. Hang out there.
We're trying this again?
I mean, you know what? There's a lot of buttons, guys. There's a lot of buttons happening
it's like
right
the
now.
The Titanic over there. You just hit an iceberg.
Here we go.
Too soon.
Too soon.
Here we go.
Too soon.
Hi, this is Celeste. I have a song request for the boys. Can we get a little PBR rendition of Sweet Caroline going?
Oh.
Thanks. And keep up the great podcast. We love it.
First of all, Derek and I met Celeste. You want to talk to us this point?
Yeah, we met Celeste at Radio City Music Hall, and awesome. Thank you so much. She was very kind. We took a picture with her, and she posted it on Twitter and stuff. We retweeted it and everything, and Celeste, you rock. And newest member of Patreon.
That's right, man.
Right?
I think we've met a couple times. I think maybe down at the Borgata in Atlantic City with Jiggy. Actually, every time I've met her,
it's been with Jiggy. Yeah. I gotta say, Celeste, I think you're great, but Sweet Caroline, that's like anytime someone does that karaoke, I'm like, ah.
So
Neil Diamond.
That's like on every Jersey Shore bar playlist.
Oh.
So what do we? Are we?
Maybe that's why I don't like it.
Yeah.
Are we gonna do a few bars?
We gotta. We're not gonna do it.
Are we going karaoke style? Or do you want to? What do you want?
I'd rather sing over.
Do I know the words?
Yeah.
Do you know what movie made this song? Really made this song famous?
No idea.
Do you? Is this trivia you're giving us or you're asking?
I'm asking.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh.
Beautiful Girls. Natalie Portman.
Really?
She played like a middle school girl.
Wait, Natalie
It's been around
Portman.
For a really, really long time.
Yeah, isn't
she had to be real little.
The song was written about Caroline Kennedy.
I think, I'm calling bullshit. I'm calling bullshit. I'm pretty sure the song has been famous since
the 60s. It has been, but I'm telling you, it can't put it back.
I thought it was about North Carolina. This is definitely a karaoke version.
I don't have the words.
You could tell by that. Wait.
Jump in.
Where it began, I can't begin to know it.
See, I don't have the words.
But then I know it's growing strong.
Ooh, that's a sexual lyric. was in the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? We don't have to do this part. We'll just say it, right? I don't want to touch you.
Hands. Touching hands. Reaching out. Touching me. Touching you. Good times never seem so good, so good, so good, so good. I've been inclined, bah, 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 to believe they never would. But now I.
There you go.
There you go.
There you go.
Not bad.
You know that sometimes you'll get the Jersey version of that, and it's instead of. Ba ba ba! It's effing whore.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's mean.
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
I don't say it. I don't say it.
You don't.
Like in the bar when that plays, people go.
Why, Sweet Caroline, Celeste? Why? Can we tweet her? Tweet at her right now. Ask her. Tell her. First of all, tell her we did it, and then ask her why.
We should have did a little Snapchat or should have did an Instagram of that just to give them a little taste.
Only if we had a producer.
Ooh, zing, Franki! It's messed up.
You didn't see that bus coming for you.
Are you ready for the next caller?
Yeah, that was fun.
Oh, man, my voice.
Hey, I just wanted to say I think you guys have a cool podcast. My name is Diana, and my telephone number is 734162. You can call me anytime. You guys, you're the bomb. Okay, peace out. Thanks so much. Hey, bye.
Should we call her right now?
Is she Canadian? No, she said, well, 727. I think we should call her right now.
Just call her right now.
What? How do you do it? Star 67? Right, star 67.
Is that still a thing?
No, yeah, I think that's right. Does that block your number?
If you use Google Voice,
no, you could turn it off on your phone. You could turn off caller ID.
Here we go. 72. Blah blah blah. Beep 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 a doop.
We're calling Dirty Diana. Oh, I'm not saying she's dirty. That's, I was just doing a rendition of.
You haven't even met her yet.
Yeah. Yeah. So we're just calling her right now. That's ringing. And if she doesn't pick up, we'll leave a voicemail.
Yeah, leave a nice voicemail for her.
I mean, it's going to say unknown.
Hello?
Hi, may I speak to Diana, please?
Who's calling?
This is Bill. I work down on the river banks at the pizza and chicken station. And you put your name in for a challenge? Is that true?
Pardon me.
I'm sorry?
Hello?
Yes?
Sorry, go ahead.
So I work down at the Chicken Station Ranch pizza place, and it's down by the river, and you put your name in for a chicken challenge.
I'm sorry. the chicken place?
No, it's chicken. Sorry. It's chicken and pizza down by the river.
You know what? I'm thinking this is kind of a gag, ain't it?
I mean, we take our chicken challenges very seriously.
Right, I know who this is.
Who is
this? It's that PBR podcast.
Hey! Hey, what's up, Diana? How'd you know that?
I tell you what. Your number got all messed up last night, but anyway, hey, you're cool. Thanks so much.
Hey, no problem at all. We wanted to call and say hi. And
she from Canada?
Yeah, where are you from?
Ruston, Florida.
Oh, Florida.
Are you originally from Florida or are you Canadian?
No, I'm from Wisconsin.
Oh, because you said A in your message. You said A, and that's very Canadian.
Yeah. Hey, who is this?
You're talking to Derek right now.
Okay, what's the other guy's name that was on there?
What, Dennis the intern?
No, the other one.
The one that just pranked you?
Why don't you say God, you, no. Like he doesn't even no, want to say
he
my name?
Want to say it.
Because she asked about me, and now he's pissed.
He's all upset.
You're talking to Derek D. How dare you want to know somebody else's name?
You have any idea who you're talking to right now?
If you guys ever have a chance, come to the Sunshine Skyway Fishing Pier.
Well, his name's Mike Polano, by the way. But
I would love to come to that fishing pier.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're cool. Yeah. You emailed me a couple times. You're cool.
Thank you very much. You know, I like to converse with you guys. If you ask me questions, I answer. I'm not like Derek D.
I answer mad questions.
Yeah, come out to the fishing pier. It's really cool, you know?
All right, you know what? One day we'll have to try to do that. We like to travel.
Yeah, camp. It's only like, you know, 1,500 miles. Why not?
We'll run on down.
Diana,
thanks so much. Thanks so much for calling me. You really helped me. I've been having a pisser of a day, to be honest with you.
I hope we brightened your day.
Yeah, I hope we brightened your day. Thanks for leaving us a message.
Yeah, we really appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah. Hey, I love you guys. Take care, okay?
Bye. Thank you. We love you.
Thanks.
Okay. Thanks so much.
Bye.
Wow, that just warmed my heart a little bit.
Isn't that great, man? That's exactly what we
That's
been talking
amazing.
About,
day
dude.
Brighter just by the chicken station pizza by the river.
I don't know. I had nothing, dude.
You've been at restaurants, right?
You need to take an improv class.
Thought it was pretty good. I went with it.
It was on the ranch?
This is
at the river?
I didn't expect her to answer, man.
My name is Schmeichel. For the chicken.
But listen, the fact that she left us a message and then we called her and she's having a bad day and now she's having a great day. And
boom.
You know what I mean? Like, that was so
good. That was very nice.
That felt great.
Yeah.
So we hope we brightened up your day. And next time you're having a bad day, just call and leave us another message.
Yeah,
Derek.
Yeah, reach out.
Just make sure you mention Derek.
We'll call
you have to say Derek or else it won't get played.
Yeah. It was weird she didn't know your name. She had to know your name. She drew a blank.
I don't know. Here you go.
We sound different over the phone than we do over the.
Clearly.
Yeah.
You ready?
Ready.
Here we go.
Come on, Mike. Play the voicemail. Man. It's dead air.
A lot of buttons. Here we go.
It's
a blast
guys.
In our headphones.
Sid.
Oh, it's Sid.
Hey, Sid.
I like your little voicemail thing. Okay. So, I decided to call in. Oh, I guess I should announce who I am. I'm Sid the Fact Checker.
Yay.
From Michigan, where it's very cold right now. And we have beaches.
Nope.
No, you don't.
But, so what I was thinking about calling in about is kind of like an armchair futurist kind of thing. So you guys probably know that I just got a Fitbit, which is pretty amazing. Tracks a lot of stuff. But what I was thinking about is with like all the stuff that you can now use to like track your accomplishments and like help you get more fit. Do you think that America will become more fit, or do you think that we're just gonna get fatter? Like, if you guys ever watched WALL-E, the cartoon movie, like all the people are in like their own little world on the spaceship after Earth gets trashed, and they end up becoming like really fat. So, yep, just That was my thoughts. Okay, bye.
All right, first things first. How do you feel, Dennis, now that Sid the Fact Checker has more airtime on this episode than you do?
I've been waiting for it.
What a strange question, but it's interesting.
So can you repeat the question?
Her question essentially is, with all these Fitbits and stuff that are out, do you think America is going to get in better shape because of all this technology, like Fitbits and all this stuff?
No.
No, no matter, over the test and the many years of life and anything we've known, there's always been a gimmick or something. This is not a gimmick. This tracks like what you walk and stuff.
It tracks your sleep,
too. It's still not going to make you go and get up and go work out. That's what the core of it is. You have to have motivation to go exercise.
This provides the motivation. I believe the Fitbit, you can challenge other people.
Okay, I guess you could say that.
That's what, if they can incorporate more fun challenges into people getting fit,
yeah, maybe,
then people will do it.
The core of it, though, is...
But you have to still want to put a Fitbit
on. You have to still want to do it. And do you think, though, that like... I think we're still going to be a pretty big.
Yeah, America is getting fatter by the second. Yeah.
Isn't Missouri like the biggest or something? Like Mississippi.
Shout out to all our fans in Missouri.
Fitbit is not going to do anything. And you know, Sid, the sad thing for you is that you'll never be able to count your steps on a beach with that Fitbit because there are no beaches.
In Michigan.
You know what I mean? Like, we can go right down the street and count our beaches, our steps on the beaches.
Yeah.
But we might do that after this episode.
I might go right down, yeah. I'll throw a rock
to
it.
You know what I mean?
Just go right down to the beach.
Sid the Fact Checker, everybody. Sid, thank you for calling in. Team Sid.
Appreciate it. Chick-ching.
Team Sid.
Wow, said by Dennis the Intern.
Dennis the Intern. She's great.
All right, here we go. We got another one.
Another voicemail.
Hey, it's Lindsay. Love the show. Great to meet you guys at the Radio City show. The question is, who would play you in a movie of your life? Thanks, guys.
Oh, that's great, man. First of all, Lindsay, we did. Derek and I met you at Radio City, and it was so great to talk to you and make fun of Jay Miller.
Yeah. Right? Oh, that's right. Yes.
That's one of my favorite things to do.
Yeah, she was back in the VIP spot.
Yep, so great to meet you. Thank you for calling in. So the question is, who would play you in the story of your life? That's a good question. Franki, you look like you want to answer that right away.
I almost feel like you should answer it for each other.
Really? Oh.
Don't open me
but
up
I know,
to that.
But I know who would play me. Like, it's so clear.
Hold on to it for a minute.
All right, I'm holding it. Does everybody know who would play them?
I would obviously play myself.
You're such a son of a bitch, right?
I didn't even see that coming.
What is wrong with you, dude?
I'm joking.
The only one who can bring you, Derek D.
You know Derek what? D. Well, no, wouldn't it be up until my life now? So once they get to, like, directed me in my 20s, I could play it, but then there'd be someone.
Oh, you have to.
I'm Derek D. Produced by Derek D.
Yeah, Derek D. Production.
You guys make me sound like I'm so conceited.
Coming soon to DerekD.com.
Which will be refreshed soon.
So 20th Century Fox just as Derek.
No, I don't know. I don't know. No, in all seriousness, I'm trying to think. Do you have someone in mind for me? You?
Well, who's the most narcissistic person?
Come on,
side?
Dude. I am not narcissistic.
Ricky Gervais.
Shia LaBeouf.
Oh, yeah. Really? Yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad.
What about, I don't know. I can't think. What about Mike?
Well, I know. I'm not going to say it, but you can make good. Who do you think would play me? I'm going to write it on this card.
I'm not going to say Joe Rogan.
Yeah,
Joe Rogan's out.
Yeah.
I could see, like, if John Favreau got fit.
John Favreau?
Yeah, John Favreau. If he got fit, he could play you.
You're saying he's John Favreau now?
No, I'm saying that he doesn't really embody what I think.
He's not my height, though. I'm 6'3". He's like, what?
6'3"? <You're> 6'1". You got maybe half an
you
inch on me.
You were standing on the top of a staircase, maybe.
John Favreau.
Favreau?
With the V, Favreau?
From Swingers?
Yeah. Who did you say? You said Rogan?
I said I'm not saying Joe Rogan, because that's like a given.
I know what you're going to say. Are you willing to do bald cap, or would you shave it?
What?
There's only one person that you think would play the best me, and that's Derek D.
I could play Mike.
Would you shave it, or would you wear bald cap?
PBR the movie. If it was for a big show starring Derek D, it was all of us and Sydney.
If it was a big movie with a big budget, I would go bald. I would do what I have to do.
Play everybody. And you would yell at the dailies, I'm just not getting enough out of me.
Dennis, you're not supposed to make funny jokes.
Frank, do you have an opinion?
I don't. Stature-wise, I think like somebody like Tom Hardy, but he's not funny, and I think you'd want someone funnier.
I don't know who Tom Hardy is.
Corey Matthews from Boy Meets World.
He played Bane.
Take back your podcast,
Inception,
Michael.
Inception and...
He's Mad Max, bro.
Yeah.
Max.
No, that's terrible. Really? That's who you go with?
I don't know. Just you guys are like, so off. Aggressive. So aggressive.
You have an answer?
About you?
Yeah, who...
No. I was trying to think of someone for Franki.
Who plays Kirby in the video game Kirby?
Driver Joe? You got nothing. All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Ice Cube?
Ice Cube. What?
I'm the white Ice Cube. Watch. I'm the white Ice Cube.
You're not black.
And you're not popping off as many MFers as he does.
He would play me very well, man.
All right.
Either him or Common.
How about this? If a different nationality actor had to play you, you're going to say it Ice Cube?
Ice Cube or Common. Or the guy who wrote The Giving Tree.
Shel Silverstein.
Google it, everybody. Get a good laugh at that, you jerks.
I guess, did you think of any for Franki?
Who would play Franki?
We can't say Dennis, because then they might have an inkling of what he looks like, and you don't want to know.
You know, just throw out 8 different actors.
I don't know. Who would play Franki?
Danny Glover would play Dennis.
But Danny Glover from Lethal Weapon 3, not 1, 2, or 4.
No.
3. From 3, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Jonah Hill.
No, you know who would be a good
Jonah Dennis? Hill would play Mike.
Mac from Always Sunny. Or Mac. Danny DeVito.
I play Danny DeVito.
Or Brad Pitt. One of those three people would be a great Dennis.
Or Glenn from The Walking Dead.
Glenn from The Walking Dead. Is
AKA
a good
Ming Chen. From Goonies. He was in Goonies. Yeah. He's also in the Bruce Lee story. It was crazy.
And he has a show on
Comic Book Men. It's on AMC. Yeah. I think Julia Roberts would be Franki.
Yeah.
Julia
like
Roberts.
Aaron Brockovich feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll take it. I'll take
laying it.
It
down.
You know who would be a good you, honestly? Besides
this isn't
you?
Honestly.
What's his name? He's the worst. He's a movie star, not an actor. Kevin Costner. He always plays Kevin
Come
Costner.
On.
But Kevin Costner in The Big Chill.
Yeah.
Are you saying Kevin Costner?
Only no, from The Big Chill.
It's right, Kevin Costner.
Costner, right, right here. Yeah, that's what
you,
I said.
That's all you got of Kevin Costner in The Big Chill.
He played wrist. The dead body in he the beginning. The that's wrist. It. That's the only movie that I think would be good from you.
No,
can we
I
move
think,
on? To
I think like... I think
here's the funny thing. If they did an all Asian cast, either, like, Derek D would want to play Derek D.
I think either, you know, Rob Lowe, Brad Pitt, Matt Damon.
That's shocking.
Any of those
right,
guys.
Let's go. Next.
Shocking. No, you know who would be good? The kid who screws the pie in American Pie.
Next. Yeah, Jason Biggs.
Jason Biggs.
Or he could be the pie.
All right, next. Cue next
Mike
message.
And mute him.
Now. Here we go.
Hey, guys. It's Julia or JJ. Or Juju, whatever you want to call
Juju
me.
Juju B girl.
Just nothing mean. I'm Vicious. Calling to say hi. Haven't talked to you guys in a while.
Hi.
Thanks for the shout out the other day from the Patreon.
Welcome.
Exclusive. So today I was sitting at lunch at Chick-fil-A and this guy wouldn't stop coughing and he wasn't covering his mouth. And that's Ooh. A huge pet peeve. I also don't like it when people chew with their mouths wide open.
Oh, it's the worst. Oh,
gross. I'm going to make it sound like a damn cow.
Yeah.
Don't live in a barn. Unless you do live on a farm, in a barn.
Then you could chew like that.
But other than that, don't chew with your mouth open.
No.
It's gross. And nobody wants to see food. It's gross. So my question that I'm asking you guys is, what are your pet peeves?
Oh, my pet peeves.
Might be a loaded question, and I'm sure Derek has plenty.
What?
What?
Back to Derek. Ooh,
wow.
See that? I almost called you Dennis.
What?
Not an insult, because Dennis is awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mike, for the Scully.
You're welcome.
I still have it, obviously.
What?
Thank you guys for the love.
What?
Hashtag PBR Posse. Peace.
I used to like Juju B-Girl.
You should be happy she said your name.
I love her.
Why do I have a lot of pet peeves?
I don't know. She just nailed you, man. She nailed everything.
What are you talking
well, you know
about?
They say, if it don't apply, let it fly.
Now, I don't know if you remember this, Dennis, but
Julia.
She's actually the only person outside of this room that has met you.
Yes.
You met her in Red Bank.
Red Bank.
The night I gave
JJ.
Her the story.
JJ. Yeah.
That is great. So wait, she did
JJ,
have a question.
Julia.
I was laughing too much, but her question was pet peeves?
Yeah, pet peeves. And then she goes, Derek, I'm sure you have plenty.
Right. Derek's number one pet peeve is when you don't talk about Derek.
No, that's what he said.
Or when you try to cast a movie about his life and not cast him.
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, you know, I mean, what's the truth is the truth.
Word is bond.
Pet peeves. There are a few people that feel entitled.
Yeah.
The worst.
Uh-huh.
Beat it. It's not yours. You didn't earn it. You can't have mine. Get out of here.
That's a good one.
Mm-hmm. And also, like, just smoking hot girls, but the personality is like two, and it just ruins
everything.
They
don't want to talk to you.
Yeah.
Like, have fun, be goofy. Just like, if you're a 10 looks wise and a 2 personality wise, you're now like a 5. You're 4.
My biggest pet peeve, I think, is people who crop dust. Especially when my mouth's open. Like, that's, can you wait till my mouth's shut? Or like, you're at a game and
is there any
and,
truth
you know,
to that? Like,
you know, when you're at a gamer, what?
Like farting the your mouth.
Yeah, because then it's like when someone farts, that's like particles leaving one person's body. And when you smell them, they enter yours and become. But this is a scientific
fact.
Science.
60% of this is scientifically proven that it becomes part of you. So if you were to fart right now and I smelled it,
are
now,
they particles?
Now you're part of me. Yes.
Or is it just, it's a smell. It's,
that's
it's
particles.
It's an aroma.
Dennis.
I think my biggest pet peeve is when you're driving.
No, I'm not asking your pet peeve. Oh. I'm asking you to back me up.
Yes, absolutely. Yo.
Dennis agrees with everything you say.
Oh, hey, Sydney Lesperance.
Cha-ching.
Fact check it that when somebody farts and you smell it, that person's particles become part of you.
Yeah. Are you now absorbing particles?
Fart particles.
True story.
Farticles.
So farticles. Like, farticles.
I mean, so if you're in a car and someone locks the windows and farts, that's a pet peeve.
That's an assault.
If you're at a game.
Oh, that's like a Dutch oven, but in a car.
Right? If you're, or turn, you know, one time.
Have you ever Dutch oven?
Here we wait. Here comes
some
gold.
Sure, I'm pretty sure somebody that was in the room that did this, but they farted in the car, locked the windows, and then cranked the heat.
Oh, that's the worst.
Because it's like recycled, you know?
And it's just.
Yeah, that person was Michael Pilato.
No, it was not.
Farting in a hot car.
Don't blame me for that.
Well, my biggest pet peeve is, you know, it's kind of simple. It's when you're driving and someone doesn't get over to the left to make a left-hand turn or all the way to the right and make a right-hand turn and won't let you get by so you can go have a life.
I do hate that.
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of subcategories for pet peeves. Driving in general, driving, you can think of it. Like, a lot of people here in America do not really know. You pass on the left, you stay to the right. You get behind someone on the left that's going like 55 miles per hour on the parkway.
You're
like,
and they made a you're not going to push me around.
They made a slowpoke law too, man, but they never enforce it.
Germany does it right. They know how to drive on a highway.
Yeah. What was it? The Autobahn, right? Left. If your left blinker's going and you're in the left-hand lane,
you stay right and you pass on the left.
Yeah. Do you have a pet peeve? Frankie's trying to boss me around over here with pointing at stuff. Do you have a pet peeve or you want to skip it?
Skip it.
All right, here we go. Last one, guys.
Hey guys, it is Roderick.
Roderick.
What up? I'm on my way. I'm traveling today. I have a day off work, so I'm commuting for 2 hours to go visit family back home. Just thought I would call in and say hey and let you guys know that I still listen. I still love you. Still love Dennis just a little bit more.
Yay!
But keep on doing what you're doing and know that you will always have the PBR posse in your corner. Be safe. Talk to you later.
That's awesome.
Nice.
Let's just end it on that. I love you, Roderick. And she's got like a kick-ass job, too. She's like a bouncer at like sporting events. Well, no, she works at Spencer's, too, right?
And her name's Roderick, and she drives on the road.
Roderick.
She drives on the road.
She's one of the first PBR posse, man. Guys, this was a great episode, man. Again, thank you to everybody who supports the show.
That was fun. Thank you so much. Yeah, we really do appreciate it.
Roundtable it real quick. Anything you want to plug? Frank.
I'm up first.
You're up. Come on.
Nothing. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for listening.
Like, she's never sat here and knows the show. You have a minute, 5 seconds to get through this. Derek T. Dennis the Intern.
What is this?
I thought you were playing him today. I don't know. I got confused.
At Dennis the Intern on Twitter. And you know what? Daredevil and House of Cards is coming out.
Yeah, my show, Fastlane Daily, just got bought by Time Inc., which is a big deal. So we'll see what happens at. Hopefully all good things. Go check out the show.
Congratulations.
PBRpodcast.com. You can find us on the web, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Give us some love, and we would love you back. We'll see you.
Goodbye. Yeah.